In the first homework question, we have to determine which of the given functions scale linearly with the input list p. Let's go through the functions one by one. This should look familiar. All sumList does is take an input list p and calculate the sum of the numbers in p. In this case, the worst and the best case are really the same, because no matter what, you traverse this for loop for the length of p. And accordingly, if you double the number of items in p, you also double the runtime, because you have to go through twice as many items in this for loop. And so the runtime of sumList scales linearly with the number of items in the list p. This procedure determines whether or not a given list p has duplicate elements. Let's go through a quick example. Here's a small list with the elements 0, 1, and 1. Going through the code here, we have I and we have j. In the first iteration of the loops, I and j are both going to be 0. That means we're looking at whether the first element is equivalent to the first element. Well, we have this case right here that says not to compare one element with the same element with itself. So j increments, and now we're comparing the first element with the second element, and they're not the same. We do that again. The first element with the third element, they're not the same. We then increment I and reset j. 0 and 1 are not the same. 1 and 1 are not the same. And lastly, we have 1 and then 2, and in this case, the second element and the third element are the same, so we're going to return true. That's how this works. Now, in order to examine the runtime, the key part here are these two for loops. For this for loop, we're going to go roughly the length of p, and for every element in p, we're also going to go roughly the length of p. This creates a quadratic runtime in relation to the number of elements in p. Namely, if we double the number of elements when p, we're going to increase the runtime of the entire procedure by a factor of 4. And here we have our mystery function. You've never seen this before, but the general structure should be familiar. Here we have a while loop, and we set I to 0, and we're going to continue this while loop until I is greater than or equal to the length of p. And looking down here, we're basically going to be iterating through p, but we're going to do it a little different than normal. If the element in p at index I is even, we're going to increment I by 2. Otherwise, we're going to increment it by 1. So the worst case for this function, in terms of runtime, is if every element in p is odd. Meaning, we only increment I by 1 for each iteration. So we're going to go at half the speed that we would if every element in p was even. Simplifying the worst case, all we have is a while loop through every element in the list p. So this is clearly linear in the worst case. I'll also note that in the best case, the runtime of the mystery function is also linear. And that may be a little confusing at first because it goes twice as fast, but we're really concentrating on the growth of the runtime. So that even if it is going twice as fast as the worst case, if we double the number of elements in the list p, the runtime's also going to double.